be fair, you should have crossed it like thunder and stuff. I could see him fuming, but then you know, he's got a great little finish at the end. And he caught some.
Well, I mean, it had the confidence afterwards after you just missed one, and the sort of crowd. I mean, the atmosphere today, and all the Wolves fans here, it's what we want at the weekend, really.
Of course, you know, we want this place packed, and if we can keep putting on performances like that, hopefully a lot more fans will start turning up, and it can only benefit the club if a lot more people come.
Definitely. Second half, we were looking to try and catch them onto the break. Now, I thought our defenders, Jones, McPeak, is it? McPike?
Hey,
do your own work,
How do you pronounce it? McPike, James, settled in well alongside Ben and yourself at the back.
Yeah, he caught me in the doo-doo though with back header, didn't he?
I thought you should have hit that.
Chocolate.
But, you know, obviously conceding 1-1. What was your thoughts on the goal going in?
But it seemed to kick us on, didn't it? We sort of invited a lot of pressure, and then they finally scored, but then we sort of took over for the next 10 minutes and then got our goal. And then we sort of sat back again, which was, you know, sometimes you've got to do that. I thought that was brilliant, fantastic. Great win.
Let's just go through the last 3 or 4 minutes. I'm going to build you up a little bit. First of all, never a penalty in my eyes.
No, there's never been a penalty. It's a funny one, I don't understand what he's doing, to be fair. You know, when you see the refs blowing you the whistle and you think, what's he doing here? And you see his arm go like that to go, you think, I'm going to chin him in a minute. He's looking kind of battering to be fair.
But he couldn't see, he didn't have a clear view of the line, then I had the best view, it was just below where we were, and you know, he didn't make any sign, but he's given that decision, so obviously he bounced Blake. I mean, he's got 18 goals this year, you face him, I see you give him a little bit of a bravado, was you giving him words of encouragement when he was going to step up?
I'm not
going to
say anything,
it's
kids around,
yeah? You don't have to swear. You can give us a, you know, you just want to wind him up, or...
No, I didn't really say anything, to be fair, I know
saying you quickly backed away when you saw the ref, but you're a bit scared of the ref.
Yeah, he's lucky he didn't, like seriously, he's lucky he didn't get a chin. Him downstairs, he said, if that had gone in, he would have said, you reckon he probably would have backed. So that would have probably been in prison for GBH.
So you're standing there, he took his run up to go back, you bounced along the line, what's your thoughts? Make yourself big, or...?
I'm saving this, that's what I'm thinking. I'm saving this, mate. And I saved it, I'm buzzing.
I mean, you know, the biggest game of the season, all those Wolves fans behind you. I mean, just the fact they went to the last minute, looked like we were going to, you know, be robbed again from when we were locked down at their place, and then that same just summed it all up, mate. And then you're obviously the hero. And you can see what it means to the fans, not just in here, but all the way around the Rico. It just sets the club buzzing.
Yeah, well, you know, it's like you say, we mentioned the last game, I gave away a bit of shit. Sorry, crap ball down at Molyneux, like, so, you know, I'm happy to make the same today, so I'll make something like that.
Well, you see, you're on the actual lead on the old engraving for the man of the match, so you've got to worry about Foxy, because you're the man up there. So, ladies and gentlemen, it's been fantastic.